Celebrate the King of Kings. Welcome, welcome. I've been singing this song right now. You know, this song has a lot of memory for me. This song is so powerful. It's, it carries a lot of memory. That's why I want to use it as an introduction. Amen. And I heard for the first time this song in, I think, in 2002, you know. And that moment, I got to know so many people in my life that time, a lot of friends, and I think you remember this, you remember this, you remember this. I want to greet Pastor Heben, wherever you are right now in the nation. I want to greet you right now. You remember you used to play this song in our cell group. God bless you. Hallelujah. And I want to greet Brother Yako, wherever you are right now. Be blessed. Oh, God bless you. I want to greet Dean, Marlene. I don't know where you are right now, but God bless you. You guys were so much blessing to us. God bless you so much. I want to bless Brother John. Oh, God bless you, Brother John. Right, I can sing now the guitar. Hallelujah for the glory of the Lord. God bless you, Brother John. Lara, God bless you wherever you are. I just want to go to the list greeting all my friends or my old friends. And we've been in a prayer together, we've been in cell group together. And you know, God used that cell group, it's like home prayer, you know, the story of the home prayer. And God used it. Oh, many of us went in a different direction, and many of us just become pastors of churches. And I just want to say, oh guys, God bless you wherever you are, God bless you, amen. I want to greet Derek and Christelle, God bless you, Derek. God bless you wherever you are. Be blessed. I believe you're still going on with the knowledge of the word of God. Stay positive, stay powerful. I want to greet Pastor Moses in Jovic. Whoa, Pastor Mo, God bless you, God bless you. I think you remember those years, amen. I want to greet Ivan, hallelujah. Ivan, God bless you, you used to be our leader. God bless you so much wherever you are, Ivan. And Susan, God bless you wherever you are. And I believe you are serving God powerfully. I've been a man of prayer and fasting. Wow, this man was powerful. I want to greet Anton, Natalie. Whoa, these people really help us open their house for prayer. You know, Anton, God bless you. God bless you, Natalie. God bless you. I want to greet Ayn. Wow, man of prayer. Ayn, man of prayer. I'm telling you, a man of prayer. God bless you, Ayn, and the faith ministry. What you are doing is incredible. Praise God. I want to greet you with daughter. Bless you, brother, daughter. Man of faith. Praise God. I want to greet you, Jean. Wherever you are, woman of knowledge of God. I want to greet you, Abigail, all the way in Israel. Be blessed in the name of Jesus. I want to greet you, Debbie, God bless you, a woman of faith, a woman that loves the Lord so much. I want to greet you, Mick. I want to greet you, Jennifer. I want to greet you, Pascal. And God bless you, whatever you are doing in the city. Oh, it's powerful. May the Lord bless you, bless you, bless you for the work you are doing in the city. I want to greet you, Juanita. Blessing, blessing. And each one of people that I might forget in those years, may you be blessed. Amen. I will send you the link so you can know that we're still together. And I just want to sing this song again for you. Yes, I'm craving my soul. It was my first time she came there and she prophesied to so many people. I was like, who is this woman is prophesying like this? Oh, the Lord is good. The Lord is good. Hallelujah. You are missing some worship right now. That's why I'm here. We are just going to sing and worship for 50 minutes, you know. And we sing and worship. I want to bless you, everybody appearing there. God bless you. God bless you. Hallelujah. Mary Tamo, bless you, man of God. God bless you, everybody appearing there. Grace, oh, woman of God in Bloemfontein, be blessed. Be blessed, guys. And yo, thank you, Ambassador. Oh, Ambassador de l'Onction. Hallelujah. The man that is in Europe is doing a great job that side. Thank you, everybody appearing right now. And, you know, I just want to read the scripture quickly. What do we do in this moment, you know? I believe that when we start to worship, God starts to change things. Because we are kind of so bombarded with this things coming in our phone every minute, a message coming up. There is this corona, there is this, it's gonna do this to you, it's gonna be dull. You know, it's so many things. I know people who start getting sick just because of the messages coming in, and it's just creating fear and fear and fear. I just felt today like, let me encourage you, you know. And what do you do also in this time of lockdown? I read Acts chapter 16, verse 25, it says, 25, it says, about midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymn to God, and the other prisoner were listening to them. Suddenly, there was such a violent earthquake that the foundation of the prison was shaken. At once, all the prison door flew open, and everyone's chain came loose. The jailer woke up, and when he saw the prison door open, he drew his sword and was about to kill himself because he thought the prisoner had escaped. But Paul shouted, "Don't arm yourself. We are all here." And I want to go to verse 31. It says, they replied, believe in the Lord Jesus and you will be saved. When you believe in the Lord Jesus, you will be saved. Praise God. When you believe in the Lord Jesus, you will be saved. You will be saved. God loves you. Thank you. God loves you guys, you know. I think they were worshiping and things start changing, you know. As they were worshiping, they knew that they have a problem. They knew that they've been put in the prison. But instead of them looking at the situation and getting a depressed night, thinking of the next day, tomorrow, how are they going to explain why they were preaching the gospel? But they decided to just start worship. They decided to just start to worship the Lord. And God sent his angels, and the prison fell down, that the doors get opened. Hallelujah. The doors got opened that day, and breakthrough took place. Amen. They were free. The chains start to fall down. I want to worship with you this 30 minutes. And I want whatever that was blocking you, let it fall in Jesus' name. Come on. I'm going to sing all the songs I'm going to sing today. They are not my song, you know. I just gonna, when I sing in tongue, then you know this is me. Hallelujah. But I'm going to sing now Michael W. Smith song. I want to like sing old songs so that we can sing it together. Many of you know it. Draw me close to you. Are you sitting and crying and worrying? I'm telling you that will be a waste of time, because it's not just about you. You know, it's the whole world. Things are happening. I want you to forget about how your business is going down. I want you to forget about how your company is going down. I want you to forget about how you might lose the job. But I want you to draw near to the Lord, because when you draw near, something is going to happen. This is a time where God wants people to come closer. God wants people to come near, because he has something for them. Look, forget everything. Come to Jesus. Focus in Jesus. There is a future for you. Something great is going to happen into your life. Don't worry. You are not the only one. When you want to worry, you just have to remember the whole world is in that situation you are into. And there is people even worse because they're a bigger company. They still have to pay people in this situation. And I want to tell you right now, let us look at Jesus. Let us look at Jesus. Amen. Praise God. And I want to sing a song. There is this people, when I pray, I always like put music and just people singing and I'm praying under them. And then I come across this band, it's called Elevation. And I just love those songs. They are songs so powerful. So I've learned one of the songs. I don't know this song very well, but I can get you there. It's a very nice song. And I like the meaning of it. That's why I want to sing it. Amen. It is so powerful. It is very inspiring. It says, oh, come to the altar. Hallelujah. We repent. That's what we do. It's the prayer of repentance. Why we repent? Because we are facing problems that nobody ever faces. We are facing situations that nobody ever faces. Things are, we don't know what is going on. And we cannot just progress praying and praying and praying. We have to stop and say, God, show us why we are going through this. You know the story of Joshua? He was attacked by the small country called Ai. He did not just progress, because he was losing. And he said, God, what do you say? And God showed him, there is a situation, Joshua. There is a man called Achan who's seen him in the nation and removed him. And when he removed him, the whole nation repented. They went, they overcame. I want to tell you right now, people, we cannot just pray, but we need to repent because something is hurting us. And why God is not intervening? It means we have to make right with God. When we make right with God, God will intervene. God will always intervene. But if he's not intervening, we have to make right with him. It means something is wrong in the system. It means something is wrong between humanity and God. And that's why everybody must repent. Whatever position, leadership position, government position, whatever position you went to, first repent. Because this thing does not choose who's who. And it's just killing people every single day. Let us repent even in our houses. God wants to see a repentant heart. Remember how the people of Nineveh repented and how God changed those people, you know. I don't care how you do it, but the people of Nineveh, they were not believers. They repented the way they understand it. And God saw that they repented. And God sent Jonah and he forgave them. Hallelujah. God says, if my people that are called by my name humble themselves, pray, and repent, I will heal their land. Guys, that's the formula for now. Is repent, God will heal us in the name of Jesus. It's not just pray. It's repent, God will heal us. Why God is allowing this thing to eat us? Why is not intervening? Let us make right with him. He will intervene. He will send his angels. He will protect us. Let us know the message of the moment is the message of repentance. It's not the message of breakthrough. It's not the message of breakthrough. It's a message of repentance. There's no breakthrough right now. Every company is closing down. Everything is closed down. Where is the breakthrough going to come from? Repent from your sin and Jesus is going to forgive you. He's going to heal you. Thank you, mighty God. Amen, amen, amen. Thank you, those who are following me right now. Hallelujah. You are no more slave. You are not a slave. You are not a slave of sin. Hallelujah. Sing with me. This is, amen. I learned this song from David Jonathan. Hallelujah. And I want to sing. It's not my song also. And it's a no longer slave. You are telling me. With a melody. So I can walk right through it. My fear were drawn in perfect love. You rescue me so I could stand and sing that I am a child of God. Praise God. And I want to encourage you people that is a time you have to let go of everything. And God loves you. God wants to do greater things. Welcome, welcome, prophetess, welcome, men of God, welcome, pastor, welcome, everybody. Today is not a leadership, it's just encouragement. I want to encourage, I want to bless somebody, you know. From Elevation Band, I've also learned this song, amen. Hallelujah. Listen to this song, amen. You who are worrying whatever is going on, where your life is going, you know, listen to this song. In Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11 till 13, he said, I have a plan for you. My plan is to prosper you. The word prosper does not just mean money. It means good health. It means good relationship with God. It means security. It means eternal life. It means things are moving forward. You are peaceful. It's a rich word. You know, certain words, we are just having one synonym and we stay on it. But prosper is a rich word. When God said, I will prosper you, my plan is to prosper you. God was not saying, I'm just going to give you money. God wants to give you good life. As we sit there in lockdown, we realize just to walk, to go from the shop to the next shop is a blessing. It's part of prosperity when you are free. But when you sit in your home like this, you start to realize a lot of things. You start to realize a lot of mistakes we've made. I believe it's a time where we are just going through the process and learning again and say, Lord, can you give me a chance? I want to do it right this time. Hallelujah. And God says, this song I just sang, he says, you take what the enemy meant for evil and you turn it for good. I believe God inspired me to say that there will be a huge revival. I believe after this corona, after this situation, there will be a huge revival. People will preach the real gospel. I'm telling you, it's going to be a time of the gospel. The preachers, when they come out of those 21 days, they're going to come out like a dog that has been locked, you know, and never been given food. I'm telling you, when you go across a dog who's been sitting 3 days, 5 days without the food, it does not care whose meat is passing in front of him. I'm telling you, this is how the preachers are going to come out when they say, it is over, preacher, go back to your church. Oh my God, I'm telling you, the preachers, I'm telling you, the pastors, they will explode, I'm telling you right now. And so this is what this song is saying. You take what the enemy meant for evil. You see, you're sitting in your house and say, it is evil. It is what? Oh, I'm struggling. But God is turning it for good. Amen. He said, this song says, I'm going to see a victory. I'm going to see a victory, for the battle belongs to you, Lord. Amen. So this moment, you know, you're thinking God is not doing anything. You're thinking, God, where are you? It's quiet, you know. But you don't know. Ask Moses. Ask Moses. Moses, what did you see at the Red Sea? Moses will tell you it was quiet. And people were crying and people were saying, Moses, you see? Moses, you see? You're supposed to leave us in Egypt. You see, now we are suffering. We are going to die. Moses! You know, God, Moses felt what you are feeling now. It was quiet. And then God says, Moses, take that stick. Hallelujah. Oh, let me sing this song. Hallelujah. God bless you. are following me live or replay or, you know, watch party, whatever the thing is, you are following me. I want to pray for you. I'm concluding now with a prayer. Let me now pray. If you never give your life to Jesus, this is the moment I'm giving you. God is giving you the chance to give your life to Jesus Christ. I want you to repeat this prayer. Lord Jesus, I come to you today. I accept you in my life. Forgive me, Lord. Oh, Lord, I know that you did not leave me. And whatever is going on into my life right now, it is in your plan. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for dying for me at the cross. Lord, I repent all my sins. I repent all my sins that I've committed. I repent. I come to you. I give my life to you. I accept you as the Lord and my Savior. Thank you for dying for me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I open my heart. The Bible says, when you knock at the door and see if one will open the door, Lord, I open my heart today. Come in. Stay with me. Walk with me. This season, come with me. I lead my life. I surrender. I surrender. I surrender. I surrender. Forgive me all my sins. I'm giving you a chance wherever you are. You know, you might be in church for many, many, many years. But if you never make a commitment, what we call commitment to me, let me explain it to you in 1 minute because I'm closing now. You know, when you have a woman, if you never repeat that prayer in front of a preacher where you say, from today, you are mine, or you know, that prayer that where we say, I do. The moment you say that prayer, it's spiritually things change. So when you say accept Jesus, you don't feel anything in the physical, but spiritually you belong to him. It's just like a man saying to his wife, from today I will be with you, and the wife saying to the husband, the way it is. So let me give you another chance. Repeat this prayer. Lord Jesus, thank you for dying for me at the cross. I accept you in my life. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I've served you for many years, but I realize I never give a commitment to you. I accept you in my life. Forgive me, Lord. I believed to go to church was my salvation, but I realize today, after this man of God talking, I believe, Lord, I never make a commitment. Today is my day, I make a commitment. I accept you in my life, Lord Jesus. Come into my heart, live into my life. Thank you for forgiving me all my sins. Thank you, Jesus, for dying for me. From today, I will take a decision to serve you and to follow you. God bless you. Father, I pray for every man, every woman that have repeated this prayer wherever they are right now. I bless them, Lord. Give them the Holy Spirit to continue and to never go back again to the things of this world. I declare and go forward, and no one shall stop you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. I also want to close by praying for somebody who's sick. I prayed for somebody who was having sickness, is in another country right now, and they were feeling some serious symptoms, and I prayed for them, and ask them to do A, B, C, D, the things that are going in our phone. And then I ask them after 3 days later, phone them, how do you feel? They say, no, I am healed. I said, did you do the A, B, C, D that I told you, you know, things that people are telling us to do? And they said, no, I was healed when you prayed for me and I was healed. I said, wow, praise God. Hallelujah. I believe. I've been praying for the sick for years, but I don't get to a place where I'm getting used to it, because it's always a miracle. Praise God. I cannot control it. I cannot tell you how it happened. But let me pray for you right now. Father, pray for the sick right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we come together to pray for the brothers and sisters in the world that are in the hospital right now with corona and everything, Lord. And any other sickness, we are praying for them right now. We are trusting you for healing, Father, of their body, of their spirit, and their soul. Thank you, Jesus Christ, for their healing right now. We agree together with the man of God following me and the woman of God following me and the believer following me right now. Father, we agree together for their healing wherever they are. Be healed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Be healed, because it is written, by the strap of Jesus Christ, we are healed. May you be healed in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. May you receive a miracle. where you are. Condemn this sickness from coming near you in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, mighty God. God bless you. I'm going to tell you again. I think tomorrow I'm going to be again having another prayer and worship. And I would like you to be there. And if you have followed this one, I would like you to share to many people that so that they can be encouraged as well. Because today was encouragement. Amen. We love you. I pray for you, men of God, that are following me. May your church grow. May God give you direction. Whatever you are doing, may God use you powerfully and give you strategy for your next move. I want to say to you, men of God, you are not going down. I'm telling you, God has a bigger plan for you. I want to tell you, men of God, you are a man of God. And God wants to encourage you. God wants to use you. Whatever you are going through, whatever you are going through, it is what God wanted you to go through so that you can get to the real plan of God. God bless you. I want to encourage you, believer, anybody who has believed in Jesus Christ, put your faith and your trust in Jesus. Nothing is impossible. May the Lord Jesus heal you, restore you, and may the Lord accept our repentance all over the world, wherever unsaved people and saved people are crying. Father, I pray, accept the world's repentance and heal our land. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Blessing. Amen.